Hi guys, welcome back to TOEFL with Juva. Today I tell you 5 mistakes that you must avoid if you want a high score in TOEFL listening. By the way, if you want to get more tips for the TOEFL and download templates, hit the subscribe button so that you don't miss the next video. Let's get started. Let's start with mistake number 1. You write down the main idea immediately. In TOEFL listening, it's highly likely that you get the question, what is the main idea of the lecture? Guys, don't make this mistake. If you write down at the beginning of the lecture the topic the professor introduces, and if you treat this as the main idea, this will definitely lower your score. So don't do that. And this was exactly my problem when I started practicing for TOEFL listening. Usually, at the beginning of the lecture, the professor introduces the topic. So he tells you what his lecture will be about. And when I listened to that, I thought, okay, this must be the main idea of the lecture. And then I immediately wrote down the topic of the lecture because I thought this is the main idea. And in the end, I chose this answer and the answer was wrong. The next time when I was listening to a lecture, I listened more attentively and I realized that most of the time the topic that the professor stated at the beginning of the lecture was not the main point of the lecture. Very often, the lecture took a totally different turn over time. And then I realized that I could only tell what the main idea of the lecture is at the end of the lecture, when I was looking back, when I had a big picture of the lecture. First, you need to listen to the whole lecture. And at the end of the lecture, you look back and you ask yourself, what does the professor want the students to know after the lecture? What is the purpose of the lecture? And then you know what the main idea of the lecture is. Let's go on with mistake number 2. You lose your focus. This is really bad, guys. Actually, if you lose focus and TOEFL listening, this can end in a disaster. This is exactly what Shirai pointed out when she talked about her TOEFL listening experience.
I would say just listen very attentively to make sure that you don't lose your focus, because when I was doing the practice test, I lost my focus and I think I fell asleep in one of them and it was bad. I was like, oh no, I couldn't do anything. But if I focused more, and yeah, if I just focused attentively and make sure that I was like really listening, yeah, then it would turn out great. Like it didn't test.
Shirai got a very high TOEFL score. If you want to know how she prepared and why she was so successful, check out this video. You can find the link in the description below. Why is focusing so important? In the listening section, you need to focus on the important information. This is the information that you need later in order to answer the questions correctly. The problem is that if you get distracted, you lose track of what is going on in the recording. What happens then is that you're sitting there listening and you have absolutely no idea where the recording is going. And when you realize that you have no idea, you have already missed important information that you need in order to answer the questions correctly. And this means that you have already lost several points. Guys, especially when you take the TOEFL in the test center, it can be really hard to focus and TOEFL listening because it may be that other candidates are taking their speaking test at the same time and you may hear what they say. So you need to make sure that you concentrate, that you focus on what is being said. I know that this can be really hard, but you must make sure that you focus, because otherwise you will be totally lost and you will not be able to answer the questions correctly. Let's go on with mistake number 3. You write down emotions. In TOEFL Listening, there may be a question that asks you about the emotion of a speaker. For example, a student goes to see his professor because he wants to extend the deadline of his assignment. And the professor is very angry about that because it's the third time that the student asks for an extension. And after you listen to this conversation, you get a question that asks you whether the professor was happy, sad, angry, or astonished about the student's request. The question now is, do you need to write down how the professor reacted to the student's request? What do you think? Most certainly, your answer will be no, right? Because you think that you can easily remember how the professor felt about that. And that's absolutely correct. Usually it's easy for us to remember how a person felt about something because we can understand why the person feels this way. And that's why you don't have to take notes of emotions. This will only cost you a lot of time. Always remember that everything you write down during TOEFL Listening carries the risk that you lose track of what is going on in the listening, that you lose your focus. And that's why you should keep your notes to a minimum. Of course, if it's difficult for you to remember the emotions of the speakers, then you should write them down. However, if it's easy for you, you don't need to do it. If you want to get more tips for taking notes and TOEFL Listening, have a look at my video about that. You can find the link to this video in the description below. Let's go on with mistake number 4. You skip a question. If you skip a question in TOEFL Listening, you cannot go back. You cannot say, oh, I don't know the answer at the moment. I come back later and solve this question. No, that's not possible. In this respect, TOEFL Listening differs from TOEFL Reading. In TOEFL Reading, you can always skip a question and go back later, although I don't recommend that, but you can do it. However, in TOEFL Listening, if you skip a question, you can't go back. You will lose a point. Therefore, always choose an answer in TOEFL Listening. Have a look at the answers, and if you don't know the answer, go with your gut, trust your intuition. In TOEFL Listening, you don't get penalty points, and that's why you should always choose an answer, because maybe the answer is correct. Let's get to mistake number 5. You spend too much time on a question. Imagine this situation. You've tried to figure out the correct answer, but you can't solve the question. You don't know the correct answer. I know this situation. I've been there. You've spent so much time trying to figure out the correct answer, and you really want to solve this question, and you think, I only need 1 or 2 more minutes. I will get there. I have to find the correct answer. Don't do it. Guys, most of the time, the answer is only worth 1 point. I know 1 point is 1 point, and you really want to get this point because you want to get a high TOEFL score. But you must not forget that there are a lot of other questions waiting for you that you need to solve. If you spend too much time on a question, you risk losing a lot more points because then you will not have the time to answer all these questions. If you can't solve a question after you have tried to figure out the answer. Trust your intuition. Choose any answer. As I said before, you don't get penalty points in TOEFL listening. And there is always the chance that this answer is correct. So choose an answer and go on with the next question. That's it. These are the 5 mistakes that you must avoid in TOEFL listening. I hope this video was helpful to you guys. If it was, hit the like button so that I know. And if you have any questions or a video wish, tell me about that in the comments below. I'd love to hear about that. And if you want to get more tips for the TOEFL and download templates, subscribe to this channel so that you don't miss the next video. I'd love to see you here next time. Bye bye.